Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what is access stare. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin our today's topic. So access stare in Azure, allowing you to store blob object data in the most cost effective manner. That is based on how frequently you are going to use it, right? Let's check it out. What are different options? Hot, that is optimized for storing data that is accessed frequently and which involves higher storage cost than the cool and archive tiers, but the lowest access cost. The cool and archive tiers are the next available options. So here the storage cost will be higher, but once you access cost will be lower. The cool access tier option, what it says is optimized for storing data that is infrequently accessed and stored for at least 30 days. So this is the another option to store your data in the access tier, in the cool tier. Like here, the lower the storage cost and higher access cost compared to hot storage. So in Azure, you have the cost is very difficult topic, but to give you a nutshell, there are two costs involved. Once you store the data, how long you store the data, that also involves a cost, and how frequently you access the data, that is called access cost. These are two costs. So in hot, you store the data in the hot layer or hot tier, it involves higher cost, but accessing becomes the lower cost. But whereas you store the data in the cool tier, the storage cost will be lower and your access cost will be little higher. That is what it is. So based on the data, or because usually the access cost won't be not much compared to storage cost, that should be ideal case why this has been designed, right? So when it comes to archive, optimized for storing data that is rarely accessed and stored for at least 180 days with flexible latency requirements on the order of hours. So this is archiving kind of stuffs, and it will be stored only for 180 days, and definitely there will be a latency requirements for you. I mean to say it is not business critical, and you need it for backup or some kind of compliance checks, you will store it in the archive mode. So low storage cost, we can say lowest storage cost, but higher data retrieval cost compared to hot and cold tiers. So these are the different options available, and based on the data you are going to use, right, how frequently you are going to use, you need to choose this access tier. There are other things you need to consider, is how I can decide it should be hot, cold, archive, right? So data that is in active use and expected to be read from the or returned to frequently. So basically it should be active data, something assume you are using a web page that launches the images, right? You have 100 images that should be launched immediately as soon as the screen is launched. Then you need to go for hot. But whereas you show the gallery, and there are very rarely it will be used, maybe recent events, those kind of things, very few people will go to it. So it depends, right? Based on what I'm trying to say is only 30 days it will reside, and it will be infrequently people will go for it. But whereas the initial launch page, you have 30 images to be loaded, that can be stored in hot. I'm just saying the examples. And in cool, short-term backup and disaster recovery, older data not used frequently. This is what I said. It is not used frequently, but sometimes someone may immediately want to check it out, then it can be stored in a cool. Large data sets that need to be stored cost effectively while more data is being gathered for future processing. So it can be it should be required for future. In that cases you store it in a cool. Archive, long-term backups, secondary backup, archival data sets. As usual, I said, it should be like backup strategies. You need to keep it. If something goes wrong, you need to take it from here. So such a things, you can move it into archive. The original data that must be preserved even after it has been processed into final usable form. Maybe it's like once you upload the data or image or anything you uploaded, it should be maintained in the raw format to compare what is the latest state. So in those cases, you need to preserve whatever you uploaded. So in those cases, you can move it as an archive. Compliance, as I said, some people need some documents, other things to be maintained for compliance purpose for a long time. In those cases, you can use it in an archive. So here there comes a total comparison between all the three options like hot tire, cold tire, archive tire. So availability is hot tire is 99.9% available. This is available 99%. So that is 1%. It will take some time. But archive tire is completely offline. It will not be available online. Once you say like I want, once you set archive, it will go offline. After you initiate I want to see this, then it takes some time to initiate this process. That is what it is. Then where this geo redundancy is available, so these two are fine. I mean 99.9% available. Then there comes the important aspect. As I mentioned before, the important aspect comes to the usage charges. So higher storage cost, lower access and transaction cost. Lower storage cost, higher access and transaction cost. Lower storage, lowest, it is not lower, it is the lowest. And highest access cost, here lower, it is not lowest but it is lower. Okay, you understand the difference here. So then minimum storage duration, you don't need to bother about it, and it is stored for 30 days, it can be stored for 180 days. Latency, time for the first byte, how long it will take when you store it in hot tire, it will be milliseconds. This also will be milliseconds, but compared to hot tire, takes some time for it to read. Whereas archive tire, it takes long time to read from there. So these are different options you need to be aware of while choosing what kind of access tier in Azure storage. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.